When you ask that question about how does it impact a case, my guess would be that, not having been a celebrity, my guess would be that there are external pressures, there are travel, there is media and time away from the children, and the judges will take that into consideration and boil it down to a five-part best interest of the child test. If someone has to be in South Africa filming a movie, who's taking care of those children? They need to have, those children need to be in a home, in a steady environment with normal routine. And, you know, what's a normal routine in a celebrity life? That's anybody's guess. Well, I think that those are very valid pictures. You don't ride around with a baby on your lap. And that's not something I've ever done, nor do I suspect it's anything anybody else does. And if they do, they need to be caught, prosecuted, and that's a safety issue. The fact that she's got cameras on her 24 hours a day tells me that she needs to be more careful. Not that it's unfair or geez, it's too bad she's under the microscope. You know what? Everybody should be under a microscope with their children. Britney Spears has a life as a celebrity, and there are things that she has to do to maintain that life. Apparently, Kevin Federline, he's decided that his best and number one priority is those children, and the courts see that. So as far as turning it around, gosh, I don't know if it turned anything around. Kevin Federline appears to be a stable influence on the children and probably the best parent for the job if it has to be a single parent. Again, the court will try to maintain a relationship with both parents. It's in the children's best interest to have a healthy view of both parents. Polygamy is something that is a crime in this country, although very seldom prosecuted. And I'm not sure why this is getting such great play. If older men are having sex with younger children, that's a crime, and that needs to be prosecuted. However, on the flip side of the coin, what I see is I see families that love their children, are caring for their children, and there's a lot of other people we might want to consider prosecuting before we start going breaking up families. This country and this world has a long history of casting dispersions on other religions, and this is a very religious tolerant country, and we prided ourselves on that. And I suspect that the case in Texas is being a little over emphasized, if you will, because if it were my call, if I were the prosecutor in that county, I would be taking into account the best interests of those children and not passing judgment on the fact that they are in a polygamous religious society. They seem to be very caring and loving parents, and my heart goes out to them. Most jurisdictions have no statute of limitations as to murder. And if he's charged with murder, if he's charged with conspiracy to commit murder, or an accessory after the fact of the murder, he could be charged. Now, accessory after the fact, there may be a statute of limitations on that. I'd have to check. But certainly, he could be tried.